a vitamin and water as a feed to a centrifuge. After feeding to the centrifuge, water is separated. There is a product, water, 100% water, and the other contaminated solid contain vitamin and water stream enter to a filter, continuous filter for separation from the mixture, or for concentration or separation from the water. After entering the continuous filter, there will be a concentrated product of vitamin 96% and 4% water, while the filtrate will contain a diluted amount of vitamin. We cannot like discharge it. No, we will take it and conduct recycle. We recycle it with the feed, so we get more benefit and we gain more money. So the filtrate from the filter or the filtration process are recycled with the feed and enter again to the centrifuge process, and the process is repeated. What we want now is to calculate the mass flow rate of the recycle. The mass flow rate will be in libra per hour, because all the feed is given in libra per hour, so it is better not to do conversion, just to stuck with the units libra per hour. It is a mass balance, because no moles are involved in this process. Let's start with the degree of freedom to help us to solve our problem. First, for the centrifuge, we will conduct degree of freedom around centrifuge. We have a number of components. Here we have the feed stream combined with the recycle stream and our feed to the centrifuge. So the feed to the centrifuge here contain two components, vitamin and water. And the product water is produced here, 100% water. So it is one component again. And for the other product is vitamin and water. So it is two components. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it is 5 components of in the centrifuge. Number of additional relations, we don't have additional relations here. Number of balance equation, we have 2 components, vitamin and water. So the mass balance, so the number of balance equation will be 2 balance equation. Number of given variables, again, we don't have any information for this field stream. We don't have information for this stream. We do have some information for the recycle, but we don't have any information for the combined feed. For the bottom product water, we do have 100% water, but again, it is not considered, as you remember. We have another product stream which contains vitamin and water. This gives us only one given variable. So for this centrifuge, we have only one given variable. Give us a degree of freedom, 5 minus 0 minus 2 minus 1, it will be a total of 2 degree of freedom. This means we need 2 additional variables in order for us to solve this problem. Not solve the problem, to get to know every unknown in every stream for this centrifuge. The other thing is the do a system boundary around the continuous filter. We have an inlet of vitamin. We have a product, the filtrate, which is a vitamin as a recycle, and the residue, if you remember from the filtration video. So it is a residue, which contains 96% vitamin and 4% water, which is the main product. So the number of component here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it is a total of 6 components. No additional relation is given. Number of balance equation, we have 2 components, vitamin and water. So we have 2 balance equation. Number of given variables here is considered as a 1 given. Here, another given. And here is another given. So it is a total of 3 givens. So the degree of freedom in this case will be 1. Again, we cannot know take this or you spot it that R is only, it's not here. If you do material balance here or system boundary here, R is not involved, it's not included. But for the continuous filter, R is included. If the degree of freedom here was 0, we will directly solve for R, because R is required. What if we get R, we solve the problem. So if the degree of freedom in the continuous filter was zero, we can solve for the R directly. But in this case, the degree of freedom is one. This means we want to know one unknown to be known, like the C. If we know the C, we will know how we can calculate R. Or if we know B, we can calculate R. So just one unknown. If it is known, we can calculate for R. So for this case, we cannot do anything for the mixing point. The other our other hope is the mixing point, because R is also one of the involved in this system boundary. We have the feed combined with the recycle and a combined stream into the centrifuge. Two components here, two components here, and two components here. So it is a total of six components. No additional relation because it is a mixing point. Number of given variables, we have two components. So the vitamin and water, so we can do two mass balance. Number of given variables here, we have the mass flow rate of the feed. We have one of the composition can be considered as a given variable. We don't have the mass flow rate of the recycle. We have one of the component of the recycle stream. So it is 1, 2, 3. We don't know any information about this stream. So it is a total of 3. This gives us only one of degree of freedom. So we also, we cannot calculate for R using the mixing point. So the other question, will this process be solved? To know this, we have to do the degree of freedom, okay? So the number of process, number of components in each stream in the process is 1, 2, 3, 4 here, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So it is 11 components. No additional relation. Number of balance equation, it is 2 plus 2 plus 2. So it is a total of 6 material balance equation for the process. Number of given variables, we have here for the field, we have the mass flow rate of the field. We have one of the components, so it is 1, 2. This will not be considered because it is only one component in the stream. This only one will be considered, one will be considered, and one will be considered. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. This giving us a degree of freedom of 0. This means that the process can be solved. Our last hope is overall. We will do a system boundary around the overall. R is internal stream, will not be considered. The only stream that will be involved on the overall is the feed stream, the W, or the water coming from the centrifuge, and the product, which is the residue coming from the filter. The number of components here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Number of additional relation is 0. Number of balance equation, it is 2 balance equation. We have 2 component, vitamin and water. Number of given variables is 1, 2. This will not be considered 3. So it is a total of 3. Giving us a degree of freedom of 0. According to the degree of freedom study, the only way to reach to R, to know the R, is to do the overall mass balance. The overall mass balance. Okay, the overall mass balance can give us two unknowns. So these streams are fully defined. For the water stream, if we do the overall, we can know the mass, the amount of the mass flow rate of the water coming from the centrifuge. We can also know the amount of residual stream of the product vitamin. So this is two components we can know. Which of them can affect the way we can find R? Okay, we want to find the value of R. So the next step is to either make a system boundary around the mixing point or the continuous filter. For the mixing point, the overall will not give us any unknowns. The unknown that we will know through the overall is the W, which is not connected by any way to the mixing point, and the B, which is not connected by any way to the mixing point. So it is no way to do the mixing point material balance. Our other hope is the continuous filter, because R is one of the streams coming out of the continuous filter. So overall will give us the B, which is one of the flow the streams coming from the continuous filter. If we know the B, the number of variables here will increase, of known variables for the filter will increase by one. So the number of given variables instead of three will be four, and the degree of freedom will be zero. Okay, so according to the degree of freedom, we can plan our solution. So we will do overall material balance, and then we will do material balance over the continuous filter. Okay, so for the overall, just one of the went around. For the overall, you have two ways to do the material balance. Either you can do vitamin or mass or total material balance or water material balance. The key component here is vitamin. If you look here, it is two, vitamin and water. Here is only water coming, here vitamin and water. If you do vitamin material balance, you will directly know the B. Okay, so vitamin material balance, the mass fraction of vitamin times the mass flow rate of the feed, 0.2 times 98, equal the mass fraction of vitamin in B times the B, the mass flow rate. So you will directly know B. If you know B, you can immediately start a system boundary around the continuous filter. So you can do the O overall or total material balance C equal R plus B. So you can get C as a function of R. You can do either a vitamin material balance or water material balance. Both are the same root. Will give you at the end, you will make a relation between C and R, C and R. So at the end, you will solve for R. Okay. So as you can see, you can use the degree of freedom to help you to solve the problem. If someone starts with the mixing point and starts with the centrifuge, he will solve also the problem, but it will take longer time. He will get confused and will waste time. But we as engineers, we want to solve the problem in the shortest way possible and the easiest way possible. The next step is to know some definition in the chemical engineering. As a chemical engineer, you will meet some of this definition, some of these terms. Distillation is a way you can separate two components, mix it together, but through the physical separation, is through the difference in the boiling point. For the scrubbing, you will meet some scrubbing tower. So what is the scrubbing tower or the scrubbing process? It is the cleaning of gas. You have gas containing some of the contamination, like the flue gas, contain, for example, SO2. You want to get rid of the SO2. So you the gas enters scrubber and meet a liquid, such as water. Water dissolves the SO2 in the water, and the gas come out clean. So it is a way to clean the gas. Strubbing, you take it in the distillation, in your study of the distillation tower. After the distillation, you get the products like the kerosene or gas oil or gasoline, but you have to adjust the boiling range to get rid of the lighter component. So the kerosene fraction enters the scrubber, and the steam is injected. So to get rid of the lighter end of the kerosene, for example. Or other way to do this is to do like the regeneration. If you did a solvent extraction and you want the solvent was used to extract some compounds, you want to take this compound from the solvent, so you enter a stripper or regenerator. Absorber is also is a process where you solvent are meeting a gas and the liquid will take. It's the same as a scrubber. Adsorber, on the other hand, it's you It is a porous material where some of the gas enter inside the pores. So it is separated from, like the impurities enter inside the pores and the gas come out clean, or the liquid are separated like the paraxylene from the metaxylene. You can separate one of them. So I think the metaxylene enter into the molecular sieve and the paraxylene come out clean. We will see a video about the distillation on the distillation column. But we have first to know there is a packing. The distillation column or the separation towers are not empty. In some cases it is empty from inside, but in most cases it contains other trays like bubble cap tray or different type of tray, valve tray, sieve tray, whatever. It is a mean of contact to provide a contact between the liquid and the gas. Or there can be a packing inside the tower, separation tower. Other type of packing, and there is other type of packing. It can be metal or ceramic or thermoplastic. Production of natural gasoline. Currently, it's not a main production, but the definition of natural gasoline, it is a light component that is after the condensation from the natural gas, contain butane, pentane, normal and iso, and heavier components. In most cases, butane are separated, and also some of the isobutane in this process are also separated. The rest are taken as for car as a car fuel. The main purpose for isobutane separation of the isobutane, it is used as a high octane number aviation gasoline. Isobutane is separated from the natural gasoline. Okay, so the process here is gasoline after the separation of pentane is injected to an isobutane tower. In the isobutane tower, isobutane is separated from the normal pentane. The normal pentane, isobutane is a gatherer product. The normal pentane is mixed with the feed again as a bivalve. So the main purpose here for the normal to mix some of the sheet with the normal pentane is to adjust the octane number of the natural gasoline. Okay, so for the natural gasoline, it can a normal pentane will be over a very low octane number. So we as you know, iso has a higher octane number. So we mix some of the iso for the feed. We get it injected by bulk and injected with the product to the adjusted octane number. So instead of 80% normal, 20% iso, it will be 90% normal, 10% iso, the rest of the iso are taking as a product. This point is a splitting point. As you know, in the splitting point, all the three streams are of the same composition, because it is the main stream and then split it into two streams. Every component in this stream are of the same composition, 80 normal, 20 iso. Here is 80 normal, 20 iso. Here is 80 normal, 20 iso. Okay, the mass flow rate of the inlet to the isobutane tower, after we get the X, we divide it by the total gasoline feed, which is F. So what we want now is X over F. We know F, so we want the X. Let's start we do a system boundary around the splitting point. You remember from the splitting point, I give you the last lecture as an example on the distillation tower. For the number of variable here, it is 2, 2, and 2, so it is 6. The additional relation, we have only one additional relation for the splitting point. We take one additional relation. The number of balance equation here is 2 balance equation. The number of given variables in the splitting point, this is a special case, so we don't consider the composition of these two streams when we are doing the splitting point. we only consider one stream only. So we have the mass flow rate for this stream. We have the mass fraction for this. So we have two given. So the degree of freedom is one. Again, we can do system boundary around the isobentane. The number of components is 1, 2, 3, and 4. We have only isobentane from the top. We have normal pentane from the bottom. So it is 4 components. Number of additional relation, we don't have any additional relation. Number of parent equation, we have 2 components, the normal pentane and the isobentane. So we can do 2 material parent equation. For the given variables, we only have the composition of this stream, which is 80%. So it is considered as one given. This is not considered a given. This is not considered a given. So we only have one given. This gives us a degree of freedom of one. The last point to do a system boundary around is the mixing point. So we have 2 components, 1 component, and 2 components. So it is a total of 5. Number of additional relation is 0. Number of balanced equation, we have 2 component number, normal and other, 2. Number of given variables, we have here 1 given, 1 given, and this is a 2 given. So the degree of freedom is 1. We want to do a process. Is the process is solvable or not? So we know now from the degree of freedom. We will consider each stream in the process. And now the splitting point is one of these processes. So we will take the additional relation into consideration. We will not take any of the composition of the stream in the process. So let's do it. For the number of components of the process, this stream we have 2 components. For this stream we have 2 components. For this stream we have 2 components. For this stream 1 component, and this stream 1 component, and this stream 2 components. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, 10. So it is 10. Number of additional relation, it is 1. We'll get the splitting point will be taken into consideration when we are doing the process, the degree of freedom on the for the process. Number of balance equation, 2 plus 2 plus 2, it is 6. Number of given variables, so we have here 1, 2. This will not be considered because it is the additional relation. So it is 1, 2, 3, and this is it. So the degree of freedom for the process, 10 minus 1 minus 6 minus 3, it will be 0. The last hope is the overall. Now the overall, we will not consider any inlets, internal streams. We will just consider the stream that is crossing the boundary. So this is stream and this is stream, so the top product of the isobentane tower and the final product of the gasoline plant. So the number of the component here is 1, 2, here 1 component, 3, and here 2 component, 4, 5. No additional relations. Number of balance number of balance equation, it is 2 balance equation. For the normal, 1 for the normal, 1 for the iso. Number of given variables, we have 1 given as a mass flow rate. The mass fraction here, 1, 2. Mass fraction here is 3. Total of 3. So the degree of freedom now is 0. We can see that the degree of freedom is 0, means that we can know any unknown in the stream. For this stream, to know the unknowns, we have the S is unknown. We have the B, the mass flow rate for the product here is unknown. Okay. The other stream is fully defined. So when you solve for the overall, you only get this component, the S and the B, the mass flow rate. For the B, it will not add anything. Remember, we need the X. So B will not add anything for in the mixing point. It will add one known for the mixing point, okay, but it will not give us X. So to calculate X, either we work with the splitting point or we work with the pentane tower. Splitting point, again, we don't have, overall we not add any unknown here. It's all known. The stream here is known. So it is clear we should work with the isobentane So if we work with the isobutene 10, the overall will give us the S. So through the overall, if you do material balance overall, we will know the value of the S. If we know the value of the S, this will add one known to the isobutene 10 tower, which is 2. So the isobutene 10 tower, instead of number of given of 1, it will be 2. So the degree of freedom will be 0. So to do our solution, we will first do overall mass balance to get the S, okay, the mass flow rate of the top isobutene 10 side stream. And from this, we do mass balance around the pentane tower to get the X, the mass fraction, the mass flow rate of the inlet stream to the isobutene tower. So for the overall here, we do total material balance F equal S plus P, and the component material balance normal pentane, we get the B. So we get from B, we get B as a function of S. We substitute here with the B. At the end, we get the value of S, okay? For the isobutene 10 tower, we do isobutene 10 component balance. So if you no, it's no need to do normal. If we do isobutene 10 from the top, and we know the first flow rate, so we can directly calculate X. So the isobutene 10, 0.2 times X equal 1 times S, okay, as you can see here. We get X and then divide it by 100, which is the value of F. At the end, we have 0.55 kilogram of the pentane free gasoline was fed to the isobutene 10 tower. So this is the solution for our problem.